private pictures front and center. Yes, sir.
I did get one of the youth guys when he was a youngster and so was I at the time. And it very quickly became known to me that shit was going to be enough to do a mainstay in the taboo trade.
Spin around and show us your back.
In the 1970s, when I started getting tattoos, you'd go in and you'd pick a design off the wall, you know, like they're called designs here in Australia. It's only been in more recent years they've been referred to as flash, the term the Americans use. But you'd go and pick a tattoo design off a sheet on the wall, and that's how you got tattooed, you know. I remember going into Tex Newell's shop in Lonsdale Street, or Little Lonsdale Street, I can't remember which it was, Little Lonsdale Street, I think. And one of the blokes asked him if he had something particular. He said, if you can't see what you want on the wall, you don't want one, son.
Said that touch shit, he never took shit from anyone, and I'm there, he still fucking don't. I'd say, don't mouth off to him because you'll fucking smack you in a gob. If you say the wrong thing, he'd smack you in a gob. Before I opened up the shop in Glenroy, I worked with Colin Creed in Dandenong. And he says to me, have you ever met Jez? Talk about Jed all the time. I said, no, I never met him. He said, you'll meet him one day, he'll come and meet you. A couple of weeks later, sure enough, Jed walks in the shop. I didn't know who he was. Dude walks in, jean jacket, jeans, pair of RMs. And he walks in and he says to me, who are you? I said, I'm Beans. And he went, you're Beans? I said, yeah, who the fuck are you? He said, I'm Jed. I said, oh, you're Jed. Yeah, he's a jackhammer. Plain and simple, mate. He's a jackhammer. He hurts. Jed hurts. Yeah. Ooh, yeah, he hurts. Every time that
feeling starts. I stand out the front of here some days, when a hot day, when people are hardly wearing anything. You think you're at a tattoo convention in San Francisco. Every fucker is tattooed. Sheilas with them on their fucking heads, necks. Fucking blokes with their arms coloured in black. Unbelievable.
Always been fun with me. I've always had a good relationship with Jen. So.
He was a young man. Keen as mustard. He's good enough to fucking throw you in a chair. Probably six different times he's worked for me. Always busy, mate. Victorian tattooists had a fucking trend to copy Dickie Reynolds.
Not true.
All these fuckers with their faces tattooed and their eyeballs tattooed, mate. Oh, can I get a photo of you, Mr. Cullen? Fuck.
In the 80s I was tattooing and it was sort of, we had a lot of stuff on the wall. It was still a lot done off the wall, but we were starting to get into neo-Japanese style then, you know, dragons and clouds. Peter Tattoo Paulus from America, and of course Hardy and all those type of guys were a big influence on what we were doing. Back in the day, Dutchie Cornelison from Sydney, he was sort of a little bit ahead of his time in that sort of Japanese work.
Man, when Jay comes to the shop, it's on.
Yeah. Can you back? bitch, you know how we get there. It's that Joe home, she feeling our staff. We come through the spot real heavy on the way.
First met Jed when I was maybe 16. My best friend at the time, Molly Kerr, was working for him on counter, and I was just starting to draw a tattoo flash then, so he used to, like, Molly would show him my drawings, and he would always give me tips and advice and, like, give me pens and things to, like, try. He's always very supportive.
He's like Jed, he looks staunch, but he's fucking not.
We appreciate when he comes through. It's time to learn, really. He's like Ballarat's Tony Soprano.
What's that, Jed? You really love me and I'm a good bloke. Yeah, thanks, mate. Promise.
It's
not for
Armistice.
No, me.
Norman, come here. Norman. Good boy. Drop.
Stick the traps out, boys. Get the traps
good
going.
Good boy.
You know, his connection with the monks is just crazy. Tattooing them, hanging out with them, you know, going to the temple, going to Thailand, just, I don't know, I never really knew anyone who did anything like that. And, you know, he's kind of working us all at the shop here up to a bit of spirituality.
They've held on to their colour. Would you like to have a look? They've hung in there okay. They're solid. Yeah. Bold will hold. He doesn't want any more. He thinks he's too old now. He's
get it out, mate. May I cut?
No.
He doesn't want any more. Okay. All right.
Tap.
They hurt. Yeah. My eyes, they hurt. All right. Cheers. Pop in my cup.
Beautiful. I guess years ago I was a bit of a lunatic, a bit out of control, and I think, as John Entwistle used to say to me years ago, you're the excitable boy. He even did a tattoo design. I lost the bloody thing somewhere. I don't know where it was. It was a skull with a stick of dynamite in its mouth, the excitable boy written around it. which is here. This is for you. This is you. So, I was out of control, and I think being, since I met my wife and hanging around the monks and everything, that sort of leveled me out quite a lot. I don't feel as loose as I used to be. It's easier to be calm, but that's probably something to do with old age as well. Yeah, no, the monks have been really great, especially Ajahn Tom and Ajahn Mahachi. They've been an influence on me for sure. Educated me, tongue in cheek, albeit the same, you know. They have made a difference. Great people, fantastic.
Good night! Long time, eh?
Long time,
Mum. That's unusual. He's always drunk.